We are just about to start period number three. For those of you just joining us, perfect timing here tonight. Florida's continuing to hold a 2-1 lead. Knocks the puck loose after a solid hit. Quick feed for Herbeck. How did he stop that one?
As a goaltender, you want to make yourself as big as possible, and that's exactly what he does right there and just takes away the net.
And that goes off a body. Slides it over with pace to Horvat. Just a little too much contact and couldn't hang on to the puck. St. Louis plays it against the boards. What a steal in his own end. Burns takes it into the offensive zone. Still has possession. Taken along the wall by Bennett. Cut grab by Reinhart. Florida's going to play it from the corner. And he turned that one aside. St. Louis has it in the defensive end. The Panthers get a hold of the puck in their own end. Here's a short pass to O'Reilly. Oh, what a save in front. Quick feed down low. The Panthers will play it from the defensive zone. Now he takes it over the line. Moves it to Kane. Sensational stop by Binnington.
When the puck's in the low slot, the goaltender gets right out next to the shooter and makes the save.
A bit of a rinse and repeat trend here going on with the personnel they're electing to go with.
Well, you have to manipulate your lineup somehow. You got to create some offensive production, James. And you got to go with your scoring players. You know how to get it done when you're trailing by one.
We got a whistle. Penalty coming up. The Panthers are being called for tripping. They get it out of the defensive end. Picked up along the boards by Cizikas. Oh, they telegraph the pass, and he picks it off. There's a chance to draw it. And he denies that great opportunity there. And manages to clear the zone. Quick pass to Fuller. The lane was plugged up, and that shot's blocked. Great read by Thomas. The Blues ready to go on the attack. It's the goal, but can't beat the post.
The Blues are working hard to get back in this game. They're wiring off the post. But they're generating offense. The coach, the staff, the entire team needs to stay confident here. They're generating the looks. They just have to find a way to execute. Thomas wasn't expecting that hit, and as a result, wasn't able to brace himself. And he takes the brunt of it, and it shows as he gets up.
Been on a roll all night long, and they continue to lead in the third.
Barkov's penalty is almost expired.
You have to look at that one as a blown opportunity as they still trail by a goal as the power play expires.
Well, that's a missed opportunity, James. An opportunity to get the equalizer on the power play. Now down by one at even strength. They're going to have to...
Oh, they're going to have a play!
That's a true competitor.
The Panthers get a hold of the puck off the draw. Look at this down the right wing. They're on the attack. Needs a puck over. Moves with the puck in the corner. Here's a shot. Oh, puck is good. He just got it out of him. Hard hit frees up the puck. Goaltender. Doesn't hit the exit. The post of the possession along the wall. And he loses control here. Fiallo's lugging the puck. Now a quick pass to Kane. Puts it on net. Shuts it down with the paddle. What a stop. Quick feed to Roy. Lays into the body on the play. Highland's thunderous hit it. Look at that. The pane of glass is cracked.
Well, yeah, I mean, what a hit, right? What a blow. And you can see it right there. There's a spidering crack. And listen, you got to make sure that this is taken care of because it gets hit again and will shatter. So safety is of the priority right now, James.
More than half the period has expired. We got a tie game. St. Louis wins the draw. Now let's see what they can do with it.
Despite having the advantage in shots.
Across the line from center. Quick shot! And it doesn't reach the net because it goes off a stick. Great forecheck by Bortuzzo. St. Louis plays it up the line. The Panthers looking against the half wall. And that's intercepted by Bortuzzo. Great use of the stick in the defensive end by Murphy. That opportunity's rejected. Takes a shot. Oh, they do it again. Grabbed along the boards by O'Reilly. And he regains control of the puck. Here's a short pass to Buchnevich. Oh, and a misfire as that goes right out of the zone. Scooped up along the wall by Bortuzzo. From his own end, he moves it up ahead.
That's how you get north in a hurry. Fantastic stretch pass.
Spectacular stop by the goaltender. How did he hang on to that?
He reads this play perfectly, James. He gets tight to the shooter. There's no room to put it by him.
Florida's time is running out in this one to try to even things up. They've had plenty of scoring chances, but no finish tonight. Horvat's won the draw here in the defensive zone.
Beautiful block shot from the defender.
Knocked away in the offensive zone.
Takes a shot. Oh, spectacular stop there.
Rebound control is critical in the game of hockey. Putting it to the corner, and now the offensive player has to hound the puck.
Oh, he hit him and got all of it.
Oh, and that's a tough one, James. You're along the boards. They don't have a lot of give. What that means, you're feeling it all.
We got a delayed penalty coming up. That trip right in front of the official's eyes. Can't get away with that. The goaltender is quickly off to his bench to get the extra attacker out. And let's see what the definitive call is on the ice.
A tough penalty to take as you're looking for the easy.
offensive zone, and they go to work. Denies the shooter on that play. And he slides it quickly to Shen. And that's a smart heads-up play by Cacikas. And the puck departs the zone. Knights now at the bench, and the extra attack is on the ice. Final horn sounds, and we are all done with this one. St. Louis has to be pleased with the result, but they kind of look like two teams that are sharing all the offense at the start, and then kind of more defending in the end.
Yeah, the last 40 minutes were more defensively structured, not generating a ton of offense. It was almost as if it was like a
Moments away from puck drop for period number three. A perfect time for those viewers just joining us here tonight. We are all tied up at three in this one here tonight. Puck picked up by Chisholm. On the attack along the boards. And he slides it quickly to Scandella. Snaps it onto the net. Stopped by the goaltender.
What an incredible glove save by the goaltender. I mean, he gets out to the top of his crease. He's challenging. He's saying, hey, try and beat me on this side.
Lots of time left in this period. It's all tied up. Columbus wins the faceoff. Feeds it to Goudreau. They're picking up steam through the neutral zone. Shot! That's gloved by Hellebuck. And the goaltender grabs that one for a whistle to try to slow things down here. And we're moments away from getting back underway here with the puck drop. Center's jammed up and the winger grabs the puck. Sends it down low. Poked away by Scandella. Sends it over to Wheeler. Along the half wall with the puck. That's turned away with the pad by Thompson. There's the whistle as
impressed me tonight, James. Just look at that last sequence and that desperation save. Unbelievable. I mean, when it's required to be calm and poised, he's got quiet feet. But when he needs to move and make a desperation play, he does it.
Nearing the midway mark of the period, Columbus leads by one. Play resumes here as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Puck is frozen and we get a stoppage in play. Columbus
Vegas holds a noticeable edge in the shot department, a big reason why they lead here in this third period. The Jets win the draw, and they go on the attack here in the offensive zone. Picked up along the boards by Wheeler. Here he is, wrists it on net. Winnipeg's got a hold of the puck now. Shot! Oh, what a shot!
Winnipeg's been working hard, and they're still in the game here. Yes, they hit the pipe, and it went out. But they're still in the game. They have to fight right to the end.
And he loses both the puck and his balance after that hit. Nice zone entry from the middle. And that's poked away. The Blue Jackets move the puck into the defensive zone. Look out, here they come on the attack. Picked up along the wall by Bjorkstrand. That knocks him off the puck. Into the offensive end now.
Columbus has the lead in this game, James, because of their second line. It's kind of like a batting lineup. You need someone firing. And when you get two, three that connect, it can make a difference. That second line's been all over the ice.
Drop here any moment to get things underway again. The Jets will start off on the attack after winning the draw. For the low slot! Stopped by the goaltender.
Well, this save looks easier than it actually is. I mean, when you have a shooter right in the slot and you know that you've got to find a way to get your glove on it, you got to be fast, you got to be quick and show those reflexes. He does that and makes the save.
And with the centers tied up, he swoops in to take possession. Columbus plays the puck along the boards. Grabbed along the board by Bjorkstrand. Pass to front. Moves it off the post. And the puck stopper jumps on top of it to get a stoppage in play. Seattle's up next, and no love lost between these two sides. A few tickets still available, I'm told, so you better get them before they're gone. The Blue Jackets will go to work here in the offensive zone. Makes his presence known on the ice. Moved up ahead after a nice pass from the right wing. Fires it! Comes up for the goal save! Puck scooped up by Gavrikov. Sends it over to Rostovic.
Lowry's made a fantastic play, James, and he's falling to the ice. He's got the puck on his stick, and he still has the ability to lower that bottom hand and find a way to redirect the puck to the net. I mean, that's tenacity, that's courage, and finding a way to compete and win your way to the net.
Past the halfway mark of this period, Columbus leads at 4-3. Back underway as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. And a nice takeaway in the defensive end by Kopp.
Shit.
played along the wing. Knocked away. The Blue Jackets have it against the wall. Moves it to Scheifele. Winnipeg's got it from behind the net. Shot, and he makes the save. Thompson's going to hang on to the puck and get a stoppage in play.
Nothing gives confidence to a team more than a big save, and he's been doing it all night, James.
Here in the late goings of the period, the Jets are hanging on to this one goal lead. They'd love to add another. Winnipeg's got it in the offensive zone. Here's a chance. There's the wrist shot. Turn that one aside.
The shot's come from the middle of the ice, and he hit at some...
Oh, no! Oh, what a save here in this third period. Absolutely clutch header.
Two good teams going at it head-to-head. It's a close game, and you got to find a way to execute, in particular when you get those golden opportunities.
Here's a chance. Takes a shot. Oh, what a save by Hellebuck.
All those tracking exercises when you're young come in handy when you're older, and this is a prime example. Look at him bob and weave trying to find that puck. He does and makes a save.
Play set to resume with the faceoff ready to go. Offense is on faceoff and he wins the draw. Looks to set up at the point now. Misses!
The Blue Jackets must be frustrated with that last miss. Returning in the third period, you have to make good on those scoring chances. It's kind of been the story of their game, James.
Moves it quickly over to Perfetti. Oh, a clutch save! Makes it look easy with the stop. Columbus has it against the half wall. And he takes the dish. Big stop by the goaltender right in front.
The goaltenders are the last line of defense for a reason, and this time, he bails his team out.
Columbus has the extra attacker out with the goalie on the bench here. And that shot goes nowhere as the lane was filled. And it's a quick pass to Bukvist. Well saved made by Hellebuck. Goaltender hangs on for the whistle. A critical face-off looms here.
And the extra attacker is on the ice, James. So much pressure on the center to win this draw.
Columbus goes to work in the offensive zone. Sacrifices the body to block that in front. A little crashing and banging forces the turnover. Scooped up along the wall by Jarrett. And there's the save.
Hellebuck's been outstanding tonight, James. I mean, he's made the saves he's had to. And really given his team an opportunity to win. You can't ask him more than that.
And there's the one. And hang on. The Jets really had to work for this one, but they
We are just about to start period number three. For those of you just joining us, perfect timing here tonight. It's a 3-1 hockey game. Quick pass to Hyman. Inside his own end, moves the puck. Offside the call, we'll get a reset. Edmonton's have been on a roll offensively tonight, and they lead it here early in this third period.
All right.
to the stick to knock the puck away. Edmonton's got possession of the puck. Intercepted at center by DeBrincat. Edmonton's got the puck in their own end. Throws one up to Dreisaitl. Broken up at center by Petrie. Edmonton's gained possession along the boards. McDavid's moving the puck through his own zone. Moves around along the half wall. Here's a feed in front. And that's blocked in front. Into the attacking end. Takes a shot. Oh, what a goal by Skinner.
Great positioning by the goaltender to redirect it to the corner, getting it out of danger.
Nice dish from the left wing. The Blackhawks gain possession. Chicago's got it in their own zone. Quick feed to McKayev. And the save.
Skinner's been a consistent...
He scores! Using the Schwartz. Shane Schwartz finishes.
Well, he gets all of this one-timer, doesn't he, James? I mean, his one leg is almost on the ground as he bears down and lets it rip.
Blackhawks have made this a one-goal game here in the third.
Might be the final dance in the third period, but there is a lot of runway as this team is on fire right now. And you saw that with that last goal as they're in striking distance. You can feel the energy. It's just popping out of them right now.
Takes a shot. Way too much congestion blocks that. Hooked away by DeMello. And he's taken down the official's arm, signaling for a penalty. Here's a short pass to Schwartz. And there's the whistle stopping the play.
Well, the one-goal lead, there's a small margin of error, James, and to protect it, you can't be in the box. Now they're shorthanded, and they're going to find a way to kill it off. Guys, with the first penalty kill of the night here, there's not too much you should be concerned about. They know how to get things done. They can shoot it down. This PK unit is ranked top 10 in the league, and let's just see what happens here.
Oh, he has the answer there with a fantastic stop. Takes it into the slot. Oh, and he misses on a great A-plus scoring chance there.
Well, he's right exactly where he wants to be. He's got the puck on his stick, just unable to put it in the mesh.
Taken along the wall by Parisi. Slides the puck down low. Battle ensues for that loose puck along the boards. And a delayed penalty coming up as he got tripped up. Here comes the sentence.
When you're down a goal, you can't generate any offense if you're shorthanded. They're going to have to be opportunistic, find a way to kill it off, and then reset the momentum.
A little more room out there with a little 4-on-4.
4-on-4 can be pretty confusing when it comes to coverage. You know that your defense have the forwards, but the forwards have to be able to contain the D as well. So it's complete defense out there.
5 seconds left. Right up Main Street and on the attack. Edmonton's penalty is expired and it scores! Just like that, we are on top.
And get to work.
The Oilers win possession here in the open ice. Chicago's got a chance to work the transition game now, shorthanded. Edmonton's trying to make something happen in the offensive zone. And another stop!
He made some consecutive saves there. He's got to be wondering where his defense are. I mean, how about a little help?
Denies him in close. And the puck stopper hangs on to get a breather here for the team.
Muzzin's been showing some frustration. question. You know, when you want to contribute as an athlete, especially when you have a strong skill set, and then you're in a pointless streak, man, the frustration grows and it builds, and you start to squeeze the tape tight.
Shoots it! Oh, how did he get a glove on that? What a stop by Vasilevsky!
McDavid's been feeling it, James. You know who else is feeling it? His teammates. They have been the beneficiaries of a great leader on the ice who's just been distributing the puck and generating a ton of offense.
Edmonton's won it. Now they'll go on the attack. Gets a club on it. Wow, what a stop by Vasilevsky. Chance to reset here on the draw. This man advantage. Can they take advantage after winning that draw? An attempt to clear the puck from deep inside his own end. The Oilers certainly didn't get the result they wanted on that power play, giving up a shorthanded marker.
The expectation when you're on a power play is to score a goal, not give up one, James. This is a tough one to take for this group.
And now it's grabbed by Anderson. Denied by the puck stopper.
I love that he swallowed this one up with his glove. It's a real threat coming from the slot area. No rebound to boot.
More than half the period left to play. We got a tie game. They take possession as he locks them up off the faceoff. Pokes the puck away. Picked up along the boards by McCoy.
Trying to play the game of percentages here. He drops into the butterfly position, making himself as big as he possibly can. But guess what? There's a few inches available up high, and the shooter converts.
Chicago's on their way to victory if they can hold down this lead through the rest of the third.
It's all about game management, but they can't just sit back and hold on. Otherwise, their opponent, they will look to attack, and they will take advantage. Put them back on their heels. Be in the offensive zone where they can't get an opportunity to attack you.
Huge steal at his own end. The Oilers are across the line and into the offensive end. That's blocked by Vasilevsky.
What an incredible save in a high-danger scoring area. I mean, right in the slot, he's in perfect position to make that club save.
Looks like the coaching staff starting to lean on their big guns here, Cheryl.
Well, I like the timing of this, James. You're trailing by one, and you got to get back in this game. You've got to find a way to get your offensive producers out there, and it's all about managing the game. That's what's being done.
Here they come on the attack down the left side. Fantastic save! Skinner's opted to hang on to the puck for a faceoff. Edmonton's been the better team tonight, in my opinion, but still, they trail here in the third period despite having the advantage in shots. Slides it across to Anderson. Into the corner of the attacking area. Moves it to Bouchard. Sends the pass over. Makes a save. Oh, can't finish.
Well, he can't finish, but a great opportunity right there. Gets a stick on it as he's crashing the net.
Here's a chance. Oh, a stop by Skinner.
You have to be quick in your crease if you want to get
scores. Chicago's been the better team tonight, Cheryl. Look at this. They've got the extra goal now here late in this third.
Yeah, and that's a huge goal, James, right? It gives you the extra cushion. It's kind of an insurance mark. You know they're going to try and pull their tender late in the third. So now you got a little more breathing room in this one.
Moves it quickly over to point. And he keeps possession. Perry's carrying it ahead. Chicago's got the puck. Picking up some steam at center ice. Good use of the body to knock them off the puck. Takes a feed at the point. The Blackhawks look to start the transition game. Puck grabbed by Middleton. Now over to the Brinkett. They've got numbers here. Oh, pass! Good point stop by Skinner.
This is where he gets his grade A opportunities. He's in tight to the goaltender, and usually he executes, but not this time.
Big time saving goal as he gets all of it with the stick. And they'll cover it up, forcing a stoppage in play.
middle stats. Quick stick off the draw wins possession. Brings the puck into the offensive end now. Quick pass to Hyman. Now a quick pass to McDavid. Here's a shot, and the goaltender comes up with a piece of it to keep it out of the net.
Well, nice save by the goaltender, and even better is that he redirects the puck to the corner to safety.
Quick feed to Hyman. That's off a stick. All sorts of pressure here in the offensive end. They are really applying the squeeze. And they'll skate it out of the zone. Shot gets a piece of it to keep it out. Handles the puck, trying to shake loose. He's in. Referee's hand goes up in the air. We got a delayed penalty coming up here.
Well, you can see the pent-up frustration. That's the second penalty of the period. Now he's put his team in a compromised position. Not to mention he's affected their rhythm.
Chicago's power play unit puts their hard hands out as they go back to work.
Being on the power play is all about making adjustments, and they can do that. They have to make that weak side wide open all night.
Recognizing they're still short-handed here as they get ready for the face-off. Sneaks away with the puck after he was tangled up on the draw. Oh, he's going to get cold on that slash. Edmonton's on the attack. Time for the officials to hand out the judgment. The Blackhawks are getting penalized for slashing.
It was all over.
moments away from puck drop for period number three. A perfect time for those viewers just joining us here tonight. The Bruins lead it by a score of 4-1. Pasternak's got the puck. He got all that hit. Still plenty of time left in this frame. The Bruins are giving their fans a lot to cheer about tonight as they lead it 4-1. And they'll start with possession. Great use of the body to knock him off the puck. Pinned up along the boards. Boston's got a hold of the puck. And now he moves it quickly to Pasternak. And he loses possession of the puck after trying to make one too many moves. Throws it in. The Bruins have it now. Moves it to Kurashev. And he takes the pass.
Pasternak's been fantastic tonight, James. I mean, he has a goal already and looking to contribute more.
Puck scooped up by Rossi. Boston's looking to break out. Into the offensive zone down the right wing. Here's a pass in front. Couldn't complete the pass. Puts it on three. Gets in front of it. Puck is frozen and we'll get a faceoff. The Coyotes are looking to get back into this one, trailing early in this third period despite having the better scoring chances. Puck is dropped and he wins the draw here in the defensive zone. And he slides it quickly to Hayden. Boston's got the puck. And he makes the save with ease. Both sides mixed up for that battle for the puck along the wall. Great read to break up the play. Looking to make something happen in the offensive zone. Oh, what a stop on the play. Gets all of it with the paddle.
Love the way the goaltender gets tight to the shooter here. The puck's in the low slot. You want to take away time? You want to take space? Goaltender does it. Makes a save.
And we got a whistle as the goaltender decides to hang on to this one.
Hall's been lighting the lamp with this point streak, playing so confident. He knows where he is on the ice, and it just seems that every time it makes its way towards the net, the puck's going in.
The Coyotes take possession. Tonight, but they finally got a positive here in the third.
They're going to have to outnumber their opponent if they want to claw back from this two-goal deficit. They're running out of runway. They're going to find a way to get some chances.
The Bruins get a hold of the puck in the open ice. Moves it quickly over to Johansson. Scores! And look at that! They answer right back.
Well, the game is a hodgepodge of counters, and this is exactly what needed to happen. They were scored on, they respond quickly, and they find themselves in a favorable spot. Well, this is an unlucky bounce, James. I mean, when you're a goaltender, you play your angles, you know your set positions, but you can't get set in a scramble like this, and it winds up in the back of the net.
Boston's performance tonight still showing no signs of let up here in this third period.
Well, they've had such an impressive performance, James. It's been dominant in all areas of the ice, and there's been no lag or no let up. The message has been clear by the coaching staff as well as everyone on the bench. Keep pushing.
And that's broken up by Tippett. Great reach with the poke check by Clifton. Fisher's got it in the defensive end. Dumps the puck in. The Coyotes get a hold of the puck along the boards. Here they come inside the neutral zone. Here we go. Puck's in deep. Brandstrom's got it in the defensive end. Up along the wing. Fires it into the offensive zone. Scrum along the wall. Picked up along the wall by Soderstrom. Poked away in the neutral zone. Taken by Brandstrom. Slides it over to Ove Kubel.
And the puck's knocked loose. From the point, they take control of it. And that's a great heads-up play in the offensive zone. Dumps it into the O-zone. Arizona's got a hold of it along the wall. Through the open ice, they're picking up steam. Here's a shot! Coyotes don't have time on their side, but they're starting to scratch back.
They're scratching back, they're clawing back, but they're going to have to take some offensive chances. D are going to have to start jumping in, opening up lanes, and creating odd man rushes.
And tries to make a diagonal pass to Goudreau. Takes the feed. Dishes it to Schmaltz. Back to the front.
Personnel they're electing to go with.
You have to manipulate your lineup somehow. You got to create some offensive production, James. You got to go with your scoring players. You know how to get it done when you're trailing by one.
Comes up with a stop. And the goalie covers up for the whistle. Calgary's on the schedule next, and tickets still available for this one, so get them before they're gone.
Pastrnak's best scoring chances come from when he's shooting the puck when it's flat and settled on the ice. He has great accuracy, and we call that his strike zone ability.
Makes the save, but barely with that one. Denies him again.
Beauty save back there. He's really owning his crease.
And he's going to cover up the puck and get a whistle.
That's a great read by the goaltender to hold on, James. They were under siege in their own zone. Now they have an opportunity to reset, refocus, and get back on their horse.
And they take possession off the draw here at their own end. Through the neutral zone, moving the puck along the side. Dunn's taking it from his own end. Inside the defensive zone, moving the puck. Fires it on net. A shot. Oh, what a great glove save on the play. Here in the back half of this period, the Coyotes make their way back into the faceoff circle, still in search of another goal. Arizona's got the puck inside the defensive zone. It's the full use of his stick on the poke check. Moves the puck into the attacking area. Puts it on net, and he makes the save. Arizona's got the puck along the boards. And he slides it quickly to Hazel. To the net, denies him.
There's been so much offense in this game, James. It's been real entertaining for us and the fans in the building. Listen, I was more of a defensive specialist, so I wouldn't have been up in the tap, but clearly the game's changing.
Official blows the play dead as the puck goes out of bounds. Just here in the late stages of this frame, the Bruins are holding on to a one-goal lead. It's 5-4. Pettersson's won it. Slides it across to Pastrnak. Boston's got the puck against the boards. Long jam in front. That's broken up. Slides the puck over. Broken up by Bradshaw. And someone's going off here as the ref's hand goes high in the air. Ahead of steam now towards the front.
Boston's top line has been just that tonight. They've contributed offensively, and they're a reason they're in the lead. Running interference plays as part of the game, but you can't impede the forward progress of your opponent. That's a 2 minutes interference call.
Guys, this power play is ranked top 10 get to the top of the crease and be square to the shooter. That's a great save.
Dragged along the board by Uyghur. And that pass goes off a stick. The Bruins gain control of the puck. Boston's got the puck in the defensive end. Poked away yet centered by Brown. Great heads up play to poke it away in the offensive end. Arizona's got possession while undermanned. They move the puck out of harm's way. Just a few seconds remaining here with this man advantage. Can they get something going here? Rossi swooping in on the attack. Big time stop there. Arizona's got a hold of it against the wall. Penalty expires, and when you look at where things sit right now, that's a huge, huge play by the penalty killers.
Frustrating here for the group that went out there, James, on this power play. A critical time of the game, an opportunity to score, and you don't do it. Real deflating.
And that's blocked away. Oh, the post off the bucket, and he keeps it out. Receives the pass. To the front. And that's knocked away by Carrier. Classic's got it along the board. Quick feed to Lala. Makes the save. And he makes that save as well. That's all she wrote from this one. Boston's quick start. Clearly the difference in this one, Cheryl, as they get all their offense in the first.
They get their offense in the first, and then they protect the lead the rest of the way. Sometimes this can bite you and go the other way when you play too defensive, but they play it safe and they keep the lead.
We are just about to start period number three. For those of you just joining us, perfect timing here tonight. Calgary's been rolling tonight, now leading 5-2. And now it's grabbed by Jones. And it's a quick pass to Keller. Ottawa's got him in the offensive zone. Sends a pass in front, and he denies that great opportunity there.
Tanev's been working so hard with the puck and without it. It's just not dropping for him. And when it doesn't drop, it can be extremely frustrating. You want to get points. You want to feel like you're contributing.
And they win the offensive zone faceoff. Score! Set a little sign of life here on the ice as they try to get back into it.
Yeah, a little bit of a momentum swing right here. And now they've got to layer it, which means they've got to have that next shift where they attack and have the mindset to drive the net.
Let's see if it's sustainable now.
Well, this goal is evidence how critical faceoffs are, and this is a clean win, a set play, actually, and it's just an explosive one-timer that beats the goaltender clean.
Ottawa's got to dig down and see if they've got a couple more of those on their sticks tonight.
If only they could start that way, hey, James?
No kidding.
But they need to look to finish with desperation. desperation and urgency if they want to give themselves an opportunity to even get their tender out.
Puck grab by Anderson. Can't maintain possession. Taken down, and the officials caught it. Let's see the call here. The Senators are going to be short-handed, tripping the call.
Great vision to see that stretch pass.
The Flames will take it behind the net. Here's a chance! Oh, he gets in front of that to make a great save! Kakinen's got the puck and he's gonna hang on.
Kachuk's a fan favorite because of his skill and creativity. He brings wild plays to life with his It's Tricky zone ability. And guys, he's a player that really pushes the boundaries of what's possible on the ice.
Slides the puck across to Sanford. Passes it over to White. Retreats with the puck inside the defensive zone. And that's intercepted by Kachuk.
Gets it as they feel like they're contributing.
Ottawa's got control of it now from their own end. Great use of the stick here at center ice. Looks to get the puck over to Kachuk. And he hangs on to the puck. Some good stick work to force that turnover. Tries to feed it over to Lindholm.
He's got two goals already. Puck's on his stick. He's hunting his third.
Kakinen's gonna hang on for a whistle. The Flames have built themselves a sizable lead here early in this third period. The Senators win the draw. Scooped up along the wall by Keller. Looking to make something happen along the boards. Can't hang on to the puck after the play. And some good footwork to kick it away. Here's a short pass to DeBrusk. Calgary's got it in their own zone. Sends a pass over. Moves the puck along the half wall. Off the club and makes the save.
Backlund's been a workhorse tonight, James, and there's just another example of it, and the entire bench knows that. They're invigorated by it. I mean, he's on his way down, he's stumbling, and he manages to find the puck and get a shot on net. That's tenacity at its best.
Now a quick pass to Shabbat. Puts the puck on net. Net is knocked off. We'll get a face-off here. The Flames can simply take this on cruise control based on the lead that they now have here in the third. Puck is dropped and we are back underway. The Flames will play it in their own end. Taken along the wall by Dubé. Excellent stick work on the play. Handles the pass. Moves it to Lemieux. And that's blocked. Puck picked up by White. Scores! And my oh my, how things have suddenly changed here.
It's the magic of one goal and the impact it can have, James. You go from a situation where you think you're out of it, and now all of a sudden you believe you're back in it. Complete change in the dynamic of the game.
The Senators have to find a way to get a couple more here if they want to
try to salvage this one.
Taking calculated risks, James, and jumping into the attack and pressing upwards. Now, you may give up some opportunities the other way, but you got to go for it.
The Flames win the draw here in the neutral zone. From the point, looks to make something happen. Solid hit on the play. Ottawa's got possession of the puck. Along the wing, up the neutral zone. Can't hang on to the biscuit after that. Monahan's got the puck in his own zone. Feeds it on over to Boyd. The Senators take possession in the defensive end.
This game is wild, James. End-to-end action. Let's just forget the defense, shall we, and just go with the goal calls.
Picked up along the boards by Jost. Takes the pass. Zadorov stick-handling in his own zone. The Flames take it along the wall. Moves it quickly over to Lindholm. Too much congestion blocks the shot. Arizona's coming up next on the schedule, and these two teams, doesn't matter where they are in the schedule, where they are in the standings, always a good contest. I'm looking forward to that. Calgary's going to start with the puck inside the offensive zone. Down the left wing, across into the offensive end. That was amazing. What a save by Primo. He carries the puck up along the wing. Whacks it into the offensive zone. Takes the feed. Quick pass to Tkachuk. Poked away in the defensive end. Into the offensive zone. Quick pass across to Chatfield. Blocked in traffic. Slides into Fermentin. Steps into the offensive end. Great save by Primo. A chance. And he shuts the door again.
Goaltender is very aware of where that puck is in that low slot area. And defends his crease by getting out, being aggressive, and taking away any of the net.
Face off looming as both centers get into position. Ottawa's won the face off. And that's knocked away by Carpenter. Quick feed to Lomberg. Carpenter's gaining momentum. Sends it into the offensive zone. Can't maintain possession after that hit. Great save by the goaltender on that redirect. Ottawa's gained possession along the boards. Sends it to the middle. And that shot's blocked. Moves the puck. And he takes the feed. Picked up along the wall by Sanford. Stopped by the goaltender.
Well, this save was way more difficult than it looked, James. I mean, there's so much traffic in front that he's fighting through to see, and he finds the puck to make the save.
The Flames get a hold of the puck off the draw. Uses the force on that hit. Here's a short pass to Keller. Slick feed. Shuts him down. A big draw looming here in the offensive zone. The Senators win it. Puts it towards the net. Denies him on the play. Anderson's moving the puck through his own zone. Back to the blue line. And the long-range shot goes off target.
The Senators have had a solid game, generating a ton of scoring chances. They just haven't been able to capitalize, and now they find themselves behind the eight ball late in the third.
Oh, he caught him!
And that's a thunderous hit along the boards. It's bone-crushing, James. You feel that one right from your toes all the way up to your shoulders. Popular finishing the check.
That's bluff by Kekkonen. Possession so critical in today's game, and the official ready to drop the puck right here. Lindholm's won the faceoff, and now let's see what they can do. Here's a chance, sends it in front. Oh, he comes up with a stop. Grabs the puck in the corner.
Thank you.